interior department. Today we are going to see about textile testing. So first, what is textile testing? Why we have to test the textile material? The definition is, it is an essential process. It is an essential process for all the textiles, either it will be in fiber or yarn or fabric, it will be any form. Before selecting the material, we have to test what are the properties it includes. Fiber, yarn and fabric. So during selection, processing and finishing. So before we go to select any fiber or any yarn and fabric, this is the first step. We have to test what are the properties that particular fiber is conductive. First stage is fiber and second one yarn and third one fabric. These are the three main segments in textile. So now what we are going to see is what are the parameters or what are the testing which is conducted for fiber, yarn and fabric, and what are the instruments used for this. So here I am telling first thing, fiber fineness. Fiber fineness and second one, fiber maturity. Fiber maturity and third one, fiber strength. Strength of the particular fiber and fourth one, least strength content. Here what is trash? The content which is unwanted, in fiber or which is present in fiber. The clean fiber is called lint. That means the trash which is removed from the fiber is called clean fiber or lint. So now we are going to see what are the instruments is going to be used for this particular fiber testing. First thing, fiber fineness. So to identify the fineness of the fiber, we use Sheffield micrometer instrument. Then to identify the maturity of the fiber, we have two different methods. One is direct method and another one is indirect method. These are the two methods used to identify the maturity of the particular fiber. In direct method we used caustic soda swelling method. Here we use caustic soda solution to identify the maturity of the particular fiber. The second one is indirect method. Here we use caustic carry method, then polarized method, then polarized light method. These are the two indirect method which is to identify the fiber maturity. And third one, fiber strength. To identify the strength of the particular fiber, we use the stellometer instrument. Then the next one, fiber length. Without having proper length or minimum length, we cannot select the fiber for the next process. So the fiber length, how to identify the fiber length is, here we use The instrument which is used to identify the fiber length is called bear shorter. Then next one, trash content. The last one, trash content. This is used to rectify the linked fiber or to remove the trash from the fiber. So that instrument is called trash clear. And then to identify trash, how much trash is present in the particular fiber. Here we are using Shirley trash analyzer. This instrument is used to identify the percentage of trash content in the fiber. So these are the primary properties which is needed for the fiber. The first one is fiber fineness. Without the fineness we cannot spin the fiber into yarn. Then second one is fiber maturity. If the fiber is immature, we cannot convert the fiber into the yarn sector. Then third one is fiber strength. The strength is the breaking strength. Then fourth one, fiber length. If you not select the proper length of the fiber, the short fiber will give a protrude effect in your fabric. Stage the trash content. Suppose if the trash is not analyzed, means the surface of the fabric will affect the dyeing and next further process. So to reduce all those things, we have to identify the content of the trash and length of the fiber and state maturity and fineness. These five are the basic fiber properties for testing in textiles. Then we move on to yarn testing. First thing is yarn count. Next one, yarn twist, that is turns per inch. And third one, yarn strength, strength of the particular yarn. Then lee strength. So 1 lee is equal to 120 yards of yarn. Then last one, yarn evenness. These are the five parameters which we have to check or we have to test before selecting the yarn. The first one is yarn count. Here we are using B.Sc balance, quadrant balance or novels balance. So these are the instruments which is used to identify the particular count of the yarn. The next one is yarn twist. Here we can see twist is nothing but number of turns given to a yarn to withhold the fibers. That's why it is called as twist. Number of turns given to the fibers to withhold the yarn. Here we can say we have S twist or SRZ twist. We have two type of different twist. SRZ twist. So to identify the twist, we can use either twist tester or contactory twist tester or electronic twist tester. These are the instrument which is used to identify the particular twist of the yarn. The next one is yarn strength. Why we have to identify the yarn strength? What's the purpose? So without having the strength, we cannot either weave or either make the particular yarn into fabric stage, because the yarn have to pass several passages and it have to withstand all those mechanical treatment. That's why here we are ensuring the strength of the yarn before entering into the next stage. So to identify the yarn strength, here we are using C single yarn, strength tester, single yarn strength tester. The next one, lee strength. So I have already told that one lee is equal to 120 yards. Here we are testing the single yarn strength, but here the lee we have the combination or combine of the yards. So one lee is equal to 120 yards. To identify the lee strength, we are using lee strength tester. This instrument is wall mounted and it have its own principle to work in it. We will see about this instrument later. Then last one is yarn evenness. What is evenness? It is called uniformity of degree. Uniformity of degree, or it is also called as degree of uniformity. How far the yarn is kept evenness in a particular angle or in a particular degree, that is called as yarn evenness. To identify this, we have the instrument which is used for this, Worcester evenness tester and spectrometer. So in the next session we have that what are the fabric testings available and what are the instruments used.